I've got that ring ting tingly, ding ding tingly too. Merry Christmas.
He's got that ding ting tingly.
All right. This is America's favorite plus-size fitness guru, Robert Fat Bob White. You're listening to the Areola Hour, the only show where you get to listen as I, Fat Bob, chug some beer, make some prank calls, hang out with my friends, have a good time, and be guys. All right. This is a very special episode. This is our Christmas special, so we're glad you're joining us for that. Please stand by. We're going to play a really good song as always. We've got one of the all-stars joining us tonight. Man, this is going to be something else. But first, as always, a really good song. So let's get this ball rolling. What do you say, Bryce?
Let's do it.
All right. Thank you once again for joining us. We are now chatting live on Facebook. My Skype username is FatBobUSA. That's all lowercase, no underscores. And Merry Christmas, by the way. And right now, as always, I have sitting in front of me something cold to drink. Tonight is my favorite drink, Red Bull and vodka, and I don't know, fellas. Y'all think I should take it to the head? What do you guys think? Well, here it goes. Yeah. Thank you once again for joining us. I'd like to wish all of my listeners Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, whatever it is you celebrate out there.
For Scientologists, what do they celebrate?
Don't they celebrate that that flying spaghetti monster? I'll show you a flying spaghetti monster. So joining us tonight, we have my co-host, Bryce.
That's me.
All right, all right. We have joining us your favorite all-star, Clarence.
Hey, baby, what's up?
All right, all right. This is a very special episode. This is going to be our Christmas special. And, Clarence, recently...
Jingle bells? Jingle bells, my friend. Jingle bells.
Jingle bells.
How's it going?
Great. Can I get an all right, all right?
All right.
All right, all right.
Can I get a eating good in the hood?
Good in the hood, baby.
All right, all right. Now, Clarence, the most recent time that you and I hung out together, we saw some very colorful characters out on the town, didn't we?
Colorful indeed. Yeah, they were a bit beyond colorful.
Now, would you care to talk about that one particular group we saw down at the ringside?
The S&M crowd.
Yes.
Yeah, well, we had the perfect view of them because it's a two-story joint inside, so we were upstairs, and they all came in various Christmas attire, Santa Claus, elves, dressed as elves, and all of this kind of jazz, and some of them, I don't know, I'm not sure if they had on bottoms or not, but they were a pretty weird crowd. There was a couple of reindeers, I think, in the group.
There was that one guy in particular. And dude, he had no shirt on, but he was wearing a leather harness and reindeer antlers. Do you remember that?
Okay. Yeah. I did see him. Yeah. He was certainly one of the more colorful characters of the group. Yeah. And you went down and you did sort of an impromptu interview with them.
Yes. I approached one of the ho-ho-hos, if you will. And do you remember...
Yeah, right.
Do you remember what it is that I said to her?
I don't. Reiterate, tell us, give us the playback.
I said, I've got that ring-ting-tingly, ding-ding-dingly-ding. I remember come the end of the night, I couldn't remember which garage that I had parked in, because within that vicinity, there are about a half a dozen parking garages. You remember before I met you at the outside of the symphony, and
right.
I remember we were tired, we were getting frustrated. I remember we were in an elevator, and
we went in the elevator looking for your car. Yeah, there were two or three more characters that they were dressed up cross dressers between Halloween costumes and Christmas costumes. So. And I don't remember what they were attired in, but it was weird. It was just a strange night.
Yeah, there was this guy. I mean, surprisingly enough, he had two banging bras with him, but some weird-ass dude.
He did.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. And he was wearing, like, this Grim Reaper-type robe. Like, these fucking bird feet. He had feet that looked like some kind of bird monster's feet. And these two banging bras. I remember the elevator that we had stepped into after that one. By then, you know, you were fed up, and there was just like this really square, you know, like business type looking middle-aged Caucasian fellow. And then of all times, you said, Bryce just farted.
Wow, did you have to leave the room?
I think you're going to have to leave the room.
Oh my God!
I think you're gonna have to leave whatever room you're in your apartment.
Silent killer.
Is a smellophone.
But the show must go on.
The show must always go on. That's how professional we are.
Just take one for the team, my friend. Take one for the endure.
Yeah, we were sharing an elevator with this guy, this business type guy, and you said, I can't believe I'm out here with all these fruitcakes. And he looked at us like we were crazy.
Yeah, right. And he was the leader of the pack of fruitcakes, yeah. It just showed me, you know, I had never, I don't think I'd been out in that area after 11, but it showed me just how St. Pete just transformed into just this weird place after 11 o'clock down there, yeah.
Well, it's a place where the freaks come out at night, and this guy, you know, in response to your comment, looked at us as though we were crazy. It was almost as if to say, you come downtown and you're surprised by seeing fruitcakes. That's like going to the South Side and complaining about black people.
Exactly, right?
It was an adventure, but as you know, as always, it was fun hanging out with you. And speaking of having fun with you, you're going to be doing a segment of Casual Encounters tonight. Is this correct?
Oh, boy, yeah, I tell you, that is quite a challenge for someone like myself who don't drink, don't smoke. I mean, I just have a glass of milk, and I'm in the bed before 10. So, yeah, that's going to be quite a challenge.
Is it warm milk?
It is. It is warm milk for sure, my friend.
Fair enough. Well, if I may, I think I will roll the music for your personalized segment. After which point, I would like for you to open, when I give you the cue, I would like for you to go into your Facebook messages and open the document entitled CC1. That's for Casual Encounters 1.
Oh, God.
Wait.
All right. I got my finger on the trigger, but I don't know, man. I tell you, I better brace myself. I have no clue as to what I'm about to see here.
Get ready now. You know, I just realized that I said that it's CC as in Casual Encounters, but that would actually be CE, right?
Right. Or Casual Counters. What should we tell you from me?
Yeah, I mean, like the counter we're leaning on right now, this is actually a very prestigious marble, and that's not a very casual counter at all. But these are going to be some...
they're going to be nasty no matter what the letters are.
Yeah, it might as well be XXX because it's nasty.
It might as well be X, yeah, there you go.
Do you know why it might as well be...
Wait, let me run and get my barf bag.
do you know why it might as well be XXX?
God, I have no idea what's about to come out the gate here. All right, let's do it.
Because it's, you know, about penises and vaginas.
Well, yeah, it's going to be a stretch trying to describe these things. I'm going to have to really stretch the diction and some words here. All right, but let loose. Let it fly. Let's see what we can do with it.
All right, well, let's roll the music.
Across 110th Street, Casual Counters ad of the week. Across 110th Street, BBWs, trannies, LGBT. Across 110th Street, Clarence is gonna talk about some freaks. Across 110th Street, listen, but don't get an STD.
All right. Now, Clarence, if you would please open the document I sent you entitled CC1.
This might be good after all. I'm having difficulties. I'm trying to find a way to open this. I can't. I'm having technical problems opening it. Let me keep trying. Let's see. Thank you.
Now, you're in your Facebook messages, right?
Yeah, it's there, but I have to find an application, I guess, to open it with. I'm sorry, this is a new computer, and
all right, fair enough. Well, yeah, you can open it with Word, right? Microsoft Word, or what
yeah,
is?
I just use WordPad.
WordPad?
Wait, something. I'm trying to. Yeah, I think I'm waiting.
And you went to CC1, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you know what? Why don't you work on that? And what we will do is. We will.
Right. We will. Go ahead. I'll work on it.
Okay, and
go ahead, I'll work on it.
Okay.
Let's go to something else.
Yeah. Right. So what we're going to do in the meantime is go to the ad directly and try to send you the assuming that it hasn't been flagged already. We will send you the URL.
Okay.
Okay. All right. You know what? It looks like it's still up, in which case, oh, but that's right, the it's blocked from your server, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't know, yeah, I guess.
Okay, what was that one you were just pointing at, Bryce?
The top one?
It doesn't seem to be there anymore. Maybe it was flagged already?
Oh, yeah.
Usually you have to refresh the page for that. Okay. Well, I'm going to send you a URL. I'm going to send you a link, okay?
Right.
And we'll see if that works.
Right.
Okay. Now, click on that, what I just sent you.
Yeah. What do we do about now? It blocked that.
It's blocked?
So it's blocked from...
Okay.
Blocking.
All right. Fair enough.
How did we do it last time, though?
What's that?
I said, how did we do it last time? Even though I didn't have this computer, but it was still open.
Yeah, I think it was already like set to open files like that. You know, it had like a default setting. All right. Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't you work on that? Just Clarence is. I mean, excuse me. Bryce here is a computer genius. What we will do. We're actually also scheduled to do a phone call from Santa follow up, which we weren't going to do until about the 20-minute mark. But what we could do is we could let you go for now, call you right back, use the phone line to do our follow-up, during which time. But before we let you go, Bryce, Mike could tell you exactly how to open it.
All right.
I mean, it's just using WordPad.
You know what? We're gonna have Bryce call you real quick, but while I do my follow-up.
I mean, that's all.
Okay. All right. Let me talk him through that. All right. So we'll get back to you, Clarence, and we'll keep this party going. All right? Okay, he's gone. All right. Now I'm going to need you know whose phone number. And now, just to give you a little background, those who are longtime fans, avid listeners of the show. There is such thing as a phone call from Santa. There are certain services and apps where you can send someone a customized phone call using their name with a recording of Santa's voice. And we sent one of those to a mutual friend of ours. Isn't that right, Bryce?
Yeah.
And... we actually arranged for this person to receive this call at noon last Saturday. And what we're going to do is we're going to call this person and basically follow up with them. And here is, I'm going to give you an idea what this consists of.
Imagine the look on your child's face when they get a personalized phone call from me. Hello, Billy. I hear you've been a good boy all year. Why,
What are the odds that this guy is a pedophile?
Your free personalized phone call from me, Santa Claus. Oh, 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 oh.
All right, so that'll give you an idea. Oh, okay. So, yeah, we had sent a mutual friend this phone call from Santa, an unsuspecting person, so we are going to call them right now and see what they thought about that. So here we go.
You've reached Courtney. I'm unavailable right now, but if you leave a message, I will get back to you as soon as possible.
The mailbox is full and cannot accept any messages at this time. Goodbye.
Wow, well, that just couldn't have gone better. But worry not, people. I have yet to let you down, and tonight is no exception. We're going to call our friends down at the Premier Adult Factory Outlet. Oh, that should be fun. And by all means, if anyone would like to call in and share some of their favorite Christmas stories, a personal favorite of mine was when I was about 9 or 10. It was Christmas morning, and we had, you know, our little stocking stuffers in a pile there. My brother, who was 8 years older than me, had his stocking stuffers, and I saw this package that contained like coins. And I asked him, I said, "Oh, what you got there? Some collector's coins?" And he's talking about, "No, don't worry about it." I said, "No, what is that? That looks cool." And you know, Mom walks up and she says, "What's the matter, Bob? Santa didn't get you any condoms?" You see, back then, possibly still now, they had what were called coin condoms. And although I haven't used them personally, they were in the likeness of coins, and they were different colors. In fact, now that I think about it, I did use them one time, and I told this one broad that if she didn't get her act together, that I would pound some sense into her. So right about now, we're going to call our friends over at the Premier Adult Factory Outlet. We'll see how that goes.
Adult Factory Outlet.
Good evening. This is America's favorite plus-size fitness guru, Robert Fat Bob White. We are now live on the Areola Hour. How are you tonight, sweetheart?
Good.
Well, good. Would you like to be famous?
No, not tonight. I'm at work.
Oh, that's a what? That's
close my store.
You're about to close the store. What time do y'all close tonight? Yes. Is it 1 or 2?
We close at 2, but we're starting closing down stuff right now.
Well, what if I wanted to come by right now and check out some movies?
Well, we're open till 2.
Well, that's good. Now, what kind of adult films do you like?
I don't really watch them, honestly. I just work here.
Really? It's just a job?
Really?
So you're not into anal or interracial or gangbangs or bukkake?
Or hand-holding?
No.
Do you guys have any of that hand-holding fetish video?
I don't know. Maybe. There's a whole slew of stuff back there.
Is there?
What about clown porn? Do you have any of that?
I don't know. You'd have to come in and look. There's all different sections.
How about congressman senator porn, where one of you is a congressman and the other one is a senator? And you guys fight over different laws on the hill.
There might be a parody movie back there like that.
Fair enough. You know, if I could ask you one more question. I remember I saw this flick back in the day. It had Ron Jeremy in it. Are you familiar with Ron Jeremy?
Vaguely.
Okay. Well, Ron Jeremy was in there, and he's with this broad, and he's
got a big peepee.
Yeah, he was sucking out her titties, right? And then he looks at the camera and says, "These are big." And the cameraman said, "See, Ron used to be a teacher, so he knows that." And my question is, if you have that film, do you have that movie?
Yeah, I think we do. Maybe not that particular one, but I think we do have some Ron Jeremy ones.
Fair enough. Well, what is your name?
My name's Tiffany.
Tiffany, we'd like to thank you. We'd like to thank you so much for taking part in our Christmas special. And can I get an all right, all right?
All right, all right.
Can I get a eating good in the hood? All right. Thank you so much, Tiffany. We'll stop by and see you sometime.
All right.
Tiffany, if you just hang around for a second, we're going to get your personal address real quick.
Okay.
All right. So let's get Clarence back on the line. So everything is good on that front, Bryce?
Yep.
All right. We have just a few minutes left, so let's go ahead and get Clarence on the line. And he's able to open the files?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So he got to sneak a peek.
Yeah. Hello?
Hey, Clarence, we have just under 3 minutes. If you could please go ahead with number one.
All right, number one, it appears what I'm looking at here is a female body, a Caucasian woman. Actually, there's really nothing gross or perverted here. It's just a full shot of a woman's body, a naked body. Actually, she's not too bad. She's a little chunky, nice breasts and all. And you can't really see any vaginal area or anything like that, or thighs are kind of squished together, but her body's really not too bad, and all it says is she's looking for some fun. MW4W from Riverview. I don't know if that man, woman, for woman.
Very good.
It says they're a real couple and who will voice verify before they give out any information. They are looking for fun on a one-time basis, not as much as you want.
Good. If you could go on to, not to rush you, Clarence, but if you could go on to number two.
Go to number two. All right, here we go. Number two. This is a picture of a black guy. They call me the run animal. He's just a black guy in a suit. M4W, man for woman. The first time he's corresponded, he says, to his website. He have a fetish. It's a little peculiar. He says he's been chastised for it in the past. He's a hand holder. He holds your hand five times a night without cramping it. He likes to hold hands. I guess that's his fetish. Just a black man, not a bad looking gentleman. I'm a suit. All right, you want me to go to number three?
Clarence, we have just under a minute. We have just under a minute left. So, if I may, one of those two ads, Bryce and I made up ourselves, and we would like for you to guess which one of those two we made up.
The guy with the hand holding fetish. Is that it?
I farted, it's wet, and I don't want to move.
Oh my God.
Yes, you guess it. Well, Clarence, we'd like to thank you so much for joining us tonight.
You're welcome, friends. You're welcome. Y'all be good. Merry Christmas to you and all your fans out there in Etherland.
Well,
everybody be safe. Don't drink too much, and definitely don't drive if you do.
Good night.
All right.